Thank you very much for the moderator and the organized committee of International Seminar on Metallurgy and Materials, ISMM 2020. Hello everyone, my name is Edi Suprayoga. I come from Material Theory and Computation Research Group, LIPI Research Center for Physics. Today I will talk about a comparative study of thermoelectric properties of monolayer, bilayer, and bulk chromium 3 iodide. Let's get started. First of all, let me give a quick review of thermoelectricity. The thermoelectric materials are class of materials that convert heat into electrical power. The electric voltage can be generated by thermoelectric materials due to the flow of charge carrier in those materials from the higher to the lower temperature region. From the microscopic point of view, this phenomena can be understood as a result of the change in the carrier distribution by temperature gradient, and the ability of the material to generate the electrical voltage from the temperature gradient can be expressed by so-called Seebeck coefficient, which is voltage difference over the temperature difference. And other parameters that can be measured by experiment are electrical conductivity and the thermal conductivity. From those parameters, we can evaluate thermoelectric performance and efficiency that define as power factor and dimensionless figure of merit, or ZT. And the preferable thermoelectric materials that have a high Seebeck coefficient, high electrical conductivity but low thermal conductivity, so that ZT is larger than 1. And there have been a lot of proposals of the material which are good for thermoelectric materials. One promising candidate is from the class of 2D materials. And this figure shows the comparison of the band gap value for different 2D semiconductor, and the gray bars indicate the range of band gap value that can be spent by changing the number of layer, straining, or doping. And the requirement to the best 2D thermoelectric materials, it should be semiconductor, high charge mobility, but lower thermal conductivity. So in this case, the best candidate for thermoelectric materials is in the red region. And in this research, we propose to investigate 2D chromium 3 iodide as a candidate for thermoelectric materials. We also compare the thin film with the bulk materials in order to obtain which structure that have the best thermoelectric performance. This class of materials is interesting because its flexibility to manipulate the electronic and magnetic properties by changing the number of layer or by doping. The crystal structure of monolayer chromium 3 iodide view from the top is shown in this figure. In this structure, the chromium ion is from a honeycomb network where 6 iodine ions surround each atom in an octahedral form, and the optimized lattice constant is around 6 angstrom. And in bilayer, the slab are stacked by van der Waals force, with the distance between the plane is about 7 angstrom. Interestingly, the magnetism in this system depend on the number of layer. Is ferromagnetic in monolayer, antiferromagnetic in bilayer, and back to ferromagnetic in the bulk structure. In this study, we investigate the possibility of those layer magnetic system for thermoelectric application. So here is our research aim. First, to investigate the electronic and transport properties of chromium 3 iodide by first principle DFT calculation. Second, compare the thermoelectric properties of monolayer, bilayer, and bulk chromium 3 iodide. And finally, find the optimized parameter to obtain the best thermoelectric figure of merit. Here is our method. First, we perform the DFT calculation by Quantum Espresso software package to obtain the electronic structure. From the obtained electronic structure, we can calculate the transport properties using Boltzmann transport equation under constant relaxation time approximation or CRTA as implemented in the bootstrap code. In this scheming, the transport distribution thing is used to calculate the moment of generated transport coefficient, or we call a thermoelectric kernel, or L, as function of energy and temperature. Accordingly, the seebeck coefficient as thermal conductivity sigma and thermal conductivity kappa from the electron contribution can be evaluated for given material using this formula. From those output, we can calculate thermoelectric performance such as power factor and figure of merit using this formula. And here is our calculation result. And the electronic structure of chromium 3 iodine was computed based on the relaxed structure. The electronic properties on this material were computed using the PAW method, or projector augmented wave, and the PBE pseudo potential was applied to describe the electron exchange in correlation interaction, and cutoff wave function was set to be 60 Rydberg to achieve the convergence in self-consistency field calculation, or SEF calculation. And the Brillouin zone integration for SEF calculation was sampled by 8x8x1k point mesh grid for 2D monolayer and 8x8x8k point mesh grid was sampled for bulk chromium 3 iodide. And spin polarization calculation was also taking into account with ferromagnetic state for monolayer and bulk, and antiferromagnetic state for bilayer. And we obtain the band structure of three sample, monolayer, bilayer, and bulk chromium 3 iodine as shown in this figure. Respectively, for spin up is blue line and spin down is red line. The ferromagnetic semiconductor state in monolayer and bulk chromium 3 iodide were confirmed with a band gap around 1.3 and 1.4 electron volt respectively. And the valence and conduction band in monolayer chromium 3 iodide are occupied by spin up electron. In other case, bilayer chromium 3 iodide is antiferromagnetic semiconductor with larger band gap is around 1.76 electron volt. And from the this electronic structure, we can calculate seebeck coefficient, electrical conductivity, and thermal conductivity as function of mu, or chemical potential. And we plot this transport coefficient for temperature 300 Kelvin or room temperature. From the result, monolayer, bilayer, and bulk chromium 3 iodide almost have the similar value of the seebeck coefficient, and it indicates that seebeck coefficient in those system are independent of the number of layers, and theoretically it can reach up to 2 millivolt per Kelvin by shifting the chemical potential, which involve the carrier concentration of the system, or by doping. And from the electrical conductivity, we can see that the electrical conductivity near the energy Fermi is almost zero for all materials due to the absence of conduction band at the energy range, moving away 0.5 eV from the Fermi level. The electrical conductivity start to increase to change for all materials at 300 Kelvin. Interestingly, the electrical conductivity of bulk chromium 3 iodide is larger than bilayer and monolayer chromium 3 iodide because the electrons can move more freely on 3D crystal rather than 2D system. And the variation of thermal conductivity from the electron contribution in the system is as function of chemical potential is shown in this figure. And the thermal conductivity appears to follow the trend of electrical conductivity, and this correlation between thermal conductivity and electrical conductivity is consistent with the Wiedemann-Franz law. To study the electrode transfer properties of the system as function of temperature, we plot CV coefficient, electrical conductivity, and thermal conductivity at Fermi energy state. From this figure, it can be observed that CV coefficient of each system has different behavior. The absolute value of CV coefficient of monolayer is almost zero below 200K and suddenly rise to 3 millivolt per Kelvin at 200K, then continue to decrease by increasing temperature. In bilayer case, the absolute CV coefficient has optimum value at 300K, whereas the in bulk system, the value is still increased by increasing temperature. It can be justified that the system become metallic at higher temperature, as shown in the electrical and thermal conductivity. And then we can define the power factor and dimensionless figure as merit on this system by using this formula. In this case, power factor of bulk chromium 3 iodate is higher than monolayer and bilayer because it higher electrical conductivity, while the CV coefficient is relatively the same. Meanwhile, the dimensionless figure of merit that shows that all of system has the same thermoelectric performance. And when the energy up to 0.5 eV from the Fermi level and reached to a value of 1, and optimal power factor of NGT can be obtained by shifting the chemical potential by 0.5 eV. Here's our summary. CV coefficient in monolayer, bilayer, and bulk chromium 3 iodide have a similar value. Theoretically, it can reach the maximum value of 2 millivolt per Kelvin. The electrical conductivity of bulk chromium 3 iodide is larger than monolayer and bilayer, implied that the bulk chromium 3 iodide has a better thermoelectric power factor. And nevertheless, the dimensionless figure of merit of the system remain the same. And thank you very much.